The other problem was with urban farming is like it was around the pretense of go find a bowls club that has extra land and do it up. And but bowls clubs have been chemical plants for fucking 60, 70 years, you know. Like I was watching those old guys do some, I watched them dig a hole at the back of the club and just pour everything into the hole that they didn't want anymore. And could you imagine what's in a bowls club?
Their wife.
Just one leg just melting into the ground. It's like if you didn't bowl well that weekend, it's like you're going in the hole, buddy. But I remember you talking to me about like people, and you were saying something along the lines of, yeah, but who spends an extra couple of dollars to get a good product? People will complain all day about how bad products are.
I heard somebody complaining today about pine nuts. I was like, it's like pine nuts, they're like $8 for 100 grams. And I'm like, but pine nuts are amazing. Who cares? Who cares that it's $8? Like,
yeah.
Shut up.
And also, do they know where pine nuts come from?
Right, right. Do you know what it costs to get a pine nut? Like, yeah. I don't know, but I'm sure it's hard.
I think the hardest question, the harder question is, why are peanuts $2 a fucking bag?
Exactly, right? I think being in manufacturing has really opened my eyes to the fact that, like, I've always paid an exorbitant amount of money for food because I'm dumb. Like, I love food and it's the only thing
but
I
you see. Also go fully sustainable, pretty damn fucking conscious.
Like, you know when a couple of months ago people were like, oh, lettuce has gone up to $10. And I'm like, I've been paying $10 for a lettuce for 10 years. You know, like, that's what an organic lettuce costs. It's expensive shit. Watermelons, $25. You know, like, that's what an organic something. If you want something with nutrients in it,
yeah,
you either need to grow it and pay with your time, or you need to pay somebody else's time.
Well, this is what I was trying to get across with the urban farm to people, right? And I was doing those boxes, like $50 for a box. Which,
that is amazing to me.
I was not very good at business. I was also idealistic, you know what I mean, dude? Yeah. Like, I'm I have to do this thing. I can't even remember where it came from, but even if you just talk pesticides, like fucking broccoli, dude. Like, I'm still not buying organic broccoli. I know what normal broccoli has in it. Mm. But people are just like, $8 for a broccoli. It's like, dude, you have no idea what the fuck, because a broccoli out of everything is a giant sponge for pesticides.
Yeah, righto.
All the surface area and stuff.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And people will just like their mentality.
But it's not, but we're never educated as well, right? Like, you never see people on TV going, hey, organic's good for these reasons. It's just like they want people to buy, everyone wants the cheapest thing, right? We're a consumer market. We want extra cash to go and do the boat and the jet ski and the holiday and the thing. And it's like, where can we save money? Well, I'm not paying, you know, $8 for pine nuts or $25 for, like, I paid $45 for a – this is probably the most crazy thing that I've ever paid for, right? And I kind of did it because I was like, that's ridiculous. No one should pay for that.
A story.
That, right? I paid $45 for a – and it was in season, a organic.
I hope it was in season, bro.
Right? It wasn't like I had to fly it in.
Oh, is that what you're saying?
Yeah. It was organic and in season. Just a pineapple. Best pineapple I've ever had in my life.
Yeah, but isn't it one per plant?
Yeah, and like grow a pineapple. Like they're hard to grow. And
they are hard.
They're going to grow in a certain spot and they've got to travel and they're heavy feeders. And
pineapples are like a permaculture brag.
Are they?
If you, yeah. If you ever see permaculture sites, someone will put up a fucking pineapple.
Yeah.
It's big business.
It's a big deal.
People are just, yeah.
People know they've done it.
Yeah, you've made something happen. $45 for a pineapple.
And I won't do it again. But glad I did it, and it was amazing, and that was worth $45.
And you didn't even peel it? You just ate it like an apple?
Wouldn't waste that shit. I blended it and just drank the whole lot.
Just scratching your throat the whole time? So delicious, so organic.
Perfect. Yeah. Money well spent.
Yeah, it's so funny, man. I look back at some of the farm stuff. It almost seems like a bit of a dream, considering that it's like 7 years of comedy now.
The longer I go along in my life, the closer I get to only being about food.
And time.
Food and time and probably education of myself and my child to be, you know, it's kind of a big deal at the moment because, like, there's this axis between education and soil. for me.
Oh, for sure.
Right now, you're right.
It's actually, like, that's what triggered me. Because the soil bit. Once you start to understand soil, you're like, oh, okay. You know, coming from chefing and everything's materialistic in terms of like, what does this apple look like? What does this fish look like? Can I cook it quickly? Can I get it out to someone? Can I get money in the bank as a head chef and all of that? Not once is there a soil indicator. And, you know, and like everyone was coming along with like farming and chefing and farm to table, and I still didn't hear about soil. I heard about like good beef or tastes good was a huge thing. Yeah. Well, it's all soil.
Soil is like pretty fringe even still, even though people have known about it for ages. You know, like not a lot of people know that soil is everything. It's life. It's the only thing that is has real intrinsic value. You are soil. We're made from soil, essentially, right? If you strip it back, soil and water, that's you.
Yeah.
I want to put myself geographically for, like, I'm looking at buying land again soon, somewhere where it's close to a good education facility, and then also somewhere that has soil.
Yeah, you know, which is hard to find in fucking start. Western Australia, dude.
WA's tough.
Jesus Christ, it's a nightmare.
Yeah, flat old land.
Sandy, silicon just sucks it up. Piece of shit. I think that like
because hating on, you just had a dig at silica.
Yeah,
fuck you, silica.
No, because I do everything the hard
silica
way.
Runs my business, man.
No, man,
it's glass, bro.
For me, it's like so. Having a kid for me, right? Well, one, I was a chef. Too hard. I don't know why I did it. Right? If I'm gonna have a kid, it can't just be a normal kid. It has to be in another country. Bunch of problems, fucking try to figure it out. Then I go and pick urban farming in Western Australia. Terrible choice. Could have done in New South Wales, been perfectly fine. Had to do Western Australia. Growing season's like 4 months. If unless you want lettuce, which wasn't $10 a kilo at that stage.
Damn it. Wrong time.
I missed the boat.
One pandemic and you would have been the next
dude, day. If I held on 6 more months. No, maybe a bit longer. Maybe 8 months, it would have been pandemic time.
No way.
And people were freaking out.
Yeah, shit.
And I would have just gone kunk, kunk, kunk. But like it was never, it was like not ever going to happen. I had to make I had to make some hard choices. I'm glad that
what
I did.
What happening with that place? Did they?
Just leveled the whole thing.
Did they?
But I'm glad they.
What about all the rocks?
Yeah, I don't know. Scooped it out. But they deserved some fucking rock scooping and stuff. They were
shit.
The other problem was with urban farming is like it was around the pretense of go find a bowls club that has extra land and do it up and go down the line. But bowls clubs have been chemical plants for fucking 60, 70 years, you know? Like I was watching those old guys I watched them dig a hole at the back of the club and just pour everything into the hole that they didn't want anymore. And could you imagine what's in a bowls club?
Their wife.
Just one leg just melting into the ground. It's like if you didn't bowl well that weekend, it's like you're going in the hole, buddy. Not the hole.
Jeremy.
Yeah. I don't know any bowling terminology, but.
Yeah, I was just hoping Jeremy was an old name.
Still contemporary, I would say. Bob's not coming back. Yeah, Bob's gone.